Our society has countless images, ideas, and stereotypes about change agents. People who help an organization transform by improving business process and interpersonal interactions. Whether influencing fashion, business, art, entertainment, science, politics, or law, these change agents have and continue to positively impact today's society on so many levels. And today, we are proud to share the story of these business owners, coaches, innovators, and thought leaders from various industries who are eager to educate, inspire, and motivate you. This is Our Voices on the Voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 WHPC.
Welcome to Our Voices Radio, powered by the Nassau Community College Foundation. My name is Natasha Nurse. I'm the owner and co-founder of Dressing Roommate, co-host of Woken Free, and the lifestyle editor of Plus Model Magazine. And this show is focused on highlighting the amazing work of powerful change agents who have a great message to share with the world. Today, I'm talking all about a new campaign launching soon called You Could Have Told Me, started by Monique Denton-Davis. And today, she's brought on with her her campaign ambassador for this wonderful campaign, her daughter, also Tiffany Wood. So who is Monique Denton-Davis? She was voted Woman of the Year by CSBS Sisters Incorporated. In 2017, Monique launched the idea of wanting to move forward with this idea of having a campaign that was going to make the college transition for our graduating high school seniors and freshman college students that much easier. And in addition to that, she does so much. She's a passionate, motivational life empowerment coach, career strategist, and author who's actually based here in Long Island, New York. She's been raised in the same area. Her passion for helping women begin early on in her life. And currently, she's also the proud founder and CEO of Embrace Your Cake, Confidence, Attitude, Kindness, and Excellence Coaching. She also, this woman's very talented. She is also a dedicated director, trainer, and recruiter who has worked for both corporate and nonprofit organizations. Ladies, Monique, Tiffany, how are you?
Hi, Natasha. Thank you so, so much for having me. I mean, who were you talking about just now? Was that me? That was awesome. I want to meet Monique. So thank you so much for having us on your show. I am super, super excited about this campaign and this project that we're launching. You could have told me. As a mom of two college graduates, one son currently in college, his second year. First year was a struggle. Second year, we're finally hitting some wins, some home runs, I'll call it.
Okay.
I figured and I realized that there's some things that students need to know before they start.
Okay.
There's some challenges that they face when they start college, and wouldn't it be nice if someone honestly and openly shared with them some of the things that can help them make a smoother transition and some of the things that can help them overcome the challenges? One of the things that's really startling in terms of statistics is how many students actually drop out of school. So 57% of students enrolled in college are not done after 6 years, right? So the average bachelor degree, you know, is 4 years, another 2 years. So you're adding on another 2 years of student debt.
Yes.
But of that 57%, 33% of them drop out entirely.
Okay. Wow.
The remaining 24% stay enrolled in school either full time or part time. But that 33%, what can we do to help them? What could we have told them that could have helped them transition smoother and possibly stay in school?
I love it.
This whole campaign is about you could have told me. Well, guess what? We're going to tell you.
Okay.
And we're going to help you. And this is going to be a phenomenal book by students for students.
I love that. And so, yeah, Tiffany, tell us a little bit about kind of what made you want to work with your mom to be a part of the You Could Have Told Me campaign.
Well, I just graduated college. I just graduated college in May on May 13th with a bachelor's degree in textiles and apparel. So upon graduation, we have always discussed what we could do to prepare students and young adults for college and for life after college as well.
Okay. And based on your college experience, what are you looking forward to sharing in the campaign?
I'm looking forward to sharing a lot on what I didn't know going in, than what I've learned while I was in college, and then coming out of college and realizing what could have helped me and prepared me better for the journey.
And what was the biggest struggle, you would say, that you experienced?
I think that the biggest struggle that I experienced would be time management and money management.
Ah, interesting. And then, Monique, what would you say had been the biggest schooling challenge that you faced?
I think the biggest schooling challenge, especially for having daughters in school, having young adults in school, to me, financially, yes, it was a strain because we want to do everything we can do to make sure that our children finish. The other thing was, becoming an empty nester. So even though it was my second time around with Tiff, I still felt sad. I'm one of those helicopter parents where every day I'm texting. Every day, how are you? How's it going? Where are you going? Are you on the train yet? You're on the way home. Are you in class? So there was also a transition for me. There's a transition for parents in terms of letting our children go and then becoming young adults.
Okay.
So that was one of also worrying about parties. And I think it's important that students are, and you could be really transparent in terms of the challenges with partying. There's a lot of challenges with dorm life. I experienced some things with both of my daughters and my son. You know, how do you prepare for that first roommate that you just might not like? So how does that work out?
Okay, interesting. For me, I would say I'm a proud Penn State alum. That's where I met my husband and co-host of Woken Free. For us, it was interesting. For me, I'd always been a very studious person. So studies and time management and stuff like that wasn't necessarily something that I struggled with. I guess there was definitely a culture shock going from Manhattan and growing up in the city to like a very isolated Centre County, Pennsylvania is a very different culture. I've never been around a lot of diverse neighborhoods. So that lack of diversity conversation wasn't new to me, but it was the type of lack of diversity, right? So, New Yorkers are used to interacting with people of different backgrounds. In Pennsylvania, there literally were people who had never seen a person of color, right? So I was that first experience and entree for that. So that was very interesting. Also, I would say I was able to figure out more about my own Black identity in college. So that was interesting. But overall, I think just mindset. I think when you're alone in college, there's a lot of like heavy stuff you're dealing with, right? All the responsibilities, like you're saying, financially, this is loans people are taking out, trying to make sure your grades are up for any kind of scholarships you have. So trying to manage everything, but then also, having a good mindset about things, because sometimes you get defeated and then you don't have mom or dad nearby. And then maybe your friends, you don't necessarily feel comfortable talking to them about that. So how do you deal with the emotional challenges of being by yourself, being present there? And that was interesting, I would say. And for Khalil, I'll speak on his behalf. he had never studied a day in his life before he went to Penn State. And that blew my mind because I've been studying since second grade. So I was furious to find out that I was working so hard. But that was his. So, it's interesting. You can have go to the same schools and all have different narratives, right? But college is interesting, and we will talk a little bit more about that. You are listening to Our Voices Radio on the Voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 WHPC. My name is Natasha Nurse, and my guests today are Monique Denton-Davis, empowerment coach, author, and founder of the You Could Have Told Me campaign, and campaign ambassador Tiffany Wood. So what are people going to be, I guess, expected to hear from in this new campaign and in the books that are being written? And you can talk a little bit more about the writing piece of it as well.
So one of the things that we're doing with the You Could Have Told Me campaign for students that are interested and even interested in becoming an ambassador, you can go to the You Could Have Told Me website. And what we're looking for are stories. We're looking for transparency. We're looking for students to be authentic and to really share stories and challenges that they face, which will help incoming freshmen make a smooth transition. I mean, it is the Little Black Handbook College Survival Guide, but ultimately we want to do more than just help these students survive. We want to help these students thrive.
Yeah.
Something that you mentioned, Natasha, and I just have to go back to this because you brought up a really great point in terms of the school that you went to in the transition. So I started off at Clark Atlanta University, which is a HBCU, and you would have thought being a person of color, being a African-American going to this school, I would have felt, you know, really happy. It would have been great. Uh-huh. Greeted there with open arms. It's funny, the loneliness that I felt during my transition. Oh, I love New York. Okay. Yeah. So born and raised in Long Island, but I love New York. I love New York City. So I am a New Yorker. So it was a challenging transition being here and then being in the South. Mm. It was also a challenging transition, and this is going to date me.
Yeah.
Okay. But I'm going to put it out there. And a lot of students that might be listening to the broadcast probably aren't familiar with Spike Lee's movie School Days.
Oh, so yeah. You taking it back.
OMG. Okay. Spike Lee's movie School Days.
Yes.
Okay. So you guys can Google this. All right. There were these two groups, and these groups were called the Jigaboos and the Wannabes.
Yeah.
And I literally, and I'm not going to give you the details on the Jigaboos and the Wannabes, but hopefully this will make you look it up. But Spike Lee, and he filmed this, it's interesting, across the street from Clark, the school, when he filmed it on Morehouse's campus. But the Jigaboos, so there were two groups of students, Jigaboos and the Wannabes. And I was in the Jigaboo group. And when I tell you that this movie was depicted exactly the way things were, even in terms of sororities and fraternities.
Oh, wow.
You know, I remember someone on campus telling me, oh, you're hanging with the wrong crowd.
Mm.
And it's really, even in terms of being African-American and it being a HBCU, there was still several challenges. But so that's an interesting fact. Check out Spike Lee, School Days, look that up.
Okay. She's schooling you all.
Getting back to one of the things that's really, that I'm really happy about and excited about is with these stories, we're looking for transparency.
Mm-hmm.
You know, how can you help someone else? A lot of students that I've spoken to so far, they talk about financial stability and they talk about managing things financially. A lot of them talk about partying. A lot of them talk about studying and not being disciplined. And one of the things that was important for Tiffany and for my daughter Sade, and one of the things with my son Coleman, is that those 4 years are important. And as a parent, I got you for 4 years.
Yeah.
But let me tell you, if it hits number five,
peace, it's been real.
Deuces.
I hear you.
But if it hits number five, you know, you're on your own. And it was really important.
Mm.
And so if I'm not going to talk about, you know, your studying habits, you can talk about those or your discipline. But it's important that you get there and you finish in those 4 years.
Mm.
Not just the financial debt and the financial strain, but to also make sure that you have a goal.
Mm.
I'm here and I can finish. I'm looking for students to share their stories about these different challenges.
Mm.
The other thing is when they visit the website, so there is several questionnaires. We have 9 different categories.
Mm-hmm.
There's several questionnaires they can answer, and each questionnaire is matched up to a category.
Mm-hmm.
And again, we're looking for students to share their story. We're looking for headshots. We're asking students to share their social media information. And we're also going to look at each submission. And once the submission has been accepted and approved by the You Could Have Told Me team, the Little Black Handbook College Survival Guide team, and we have an awesome team. So we have this awesome consultant that is, when I say keeping the project on point, okay?
Yes.
And she's really doing a fabulous job. But after the submissions are reviewed and approved, then what we'll do is send the students an email and we'll send them an agreement and also information on how they can invest.
Okay, gotcha. So it sounds like this is going to be very cathartic for people, and it's also going to be an educational and inspirational opportunity for everyone reading, for everyone participating. And you know, I think it's going to be interesting to hear the stories, right? It's going to be interesting to hear from someone who went to like maybe Alabama State University or University of Pennsylvania or University of Florida. Like every college campus has its own culture. You are listening to Our Voices Radio on the voice of Nassau Community College 90.3 WHPC. My name is Natasha Nurse, and my guests today are Monique Denton-Davis, empowerment coach, author, and founder of You Could Have Told Me campaign, and campaign ambassador Tiffany Wood. We will now go to a break.
Hi, Hi, I'm Janelle Hale, founder and CEO of the National Breast Cancer Foundation. Early detection saved my life. It could save yours, too. I was only 34 years old and the mother of three when I was diagnosed with breast cancer. I was forced to make a decision about my health with few options.